This is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I am your host Vaishnavi, and these are the major news stories of Thursday, October 31, 2024. Indian-Chinese troops exchange Diwali sweets at border points a week after disengagement. Israel's military announced on Thursday that it shot down a drone on Wednesday that was attempting to smuggle weapons from Egyptian territory into Israel. Spain issued another storm warning on Thursday for parts of the Valencia region, which has been devastated by floods that have claimed at least 95 lives. Amid controversy regarding the use of an ambulance to reach the Thrissurpuram venue after reports of disruptions to the festival, Union Minister Suresh Gopi dared the Kerala government to initiate a CBI investigation. The Cartons have won upon Hortus, the art and literature festival organised by Malayala Manorama in Kozhikode. Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan inaugurated the festival at a function held at the open-air stadium on Kozhikode Beach. Let's get into details. Troops of India and China exchanged sweets at several border points along the line of actual control, including at locations in eastern Ladakh, on the occasion of Diwali on Thursday. The traditional practice was observed a day after both countries completed troop disengagement at the two friction points at Demtok and Demsang Plains in eastern Ladakh, bringing a fresh thaw in the Sino-Indian ties. The exchange took place at all five border personal meeting points along the LAC. Israel's military announced on Thursday that it shot down a drone on Wednesday that was attempting to smuggle weapons from Egyptian territory into Israel. Israeli officials have previously stated that during the ongoing conflict in Gaza, the Palestinian armed group Hamas has used tunnels beneath the border to facilitate arms smuggling from Egypt's Sinai region. In response, Egypt claims to have destroyed tunnel networks leading to Gaza years ago and has established a buffer zone and border fortifications to prevent smuggling activities. Spain issued another storm warning on Thursday for parts of the Valencia region, which has been devastated by floods that have claimed at least 95 lives. Rescuers continue to search flooded fields and stranded vehicles for those still missing. Local authorities have not revealed how many people remain unaccounted for following Europe's deadliest floods in years. Meteorologists reported that parts of Valencia received a year's worth of rain in just 8 hours on Tuesday, causing severe traffic pileups and flooding farmland in the region that produces about two-thirds of Spain's citrus fruit, a major global exporter of oranges. The storm responsible for the torrential downpours have since moved northeast. Amid controversy regarding the use of an ambulance to reach the Thrissurpuram venue after reports of disruptions to the festival, Union Minister Suresh Gopi on Thursday detailed the events surrounding the incident and called for a CBI investigation. Gopi, the Union Minister of State for Petroleum, Natural Gas and Tourism, acknowledged that he arrived at the festival site in an ambulance but insisted that he initially reached the area in his car. He claimed his vehicle was attacked by gundas from rival party and that he was subsequently assisted by local youths who placed him in an ambulance designated for festival emergencies. He also alleged that these controversies were being manufactured to divert attention from financial scandals, including the Karvanur Cooperative Bank scam. The Hortus Art and Literature Festival organized by Malayala Manorama has officially begun in Kozhikode. Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan inaugurated the event at open-air stadium on Kozhikode Beach, with Kozhikode Mayor Beena Philip presiding. The festival features speeches from notable figures including Malayala Manorama Executive Editor Jayant Maman Matthew and Polish writer Marek Binzak. Running from number 1 to 3, Hortus will host over 130 debates across 10 venues and welcome more than 400 guests, including Tamil Nadu Deputy Chief Minister Udayanidhi Stalin and Delhi Chief Minister Atishi. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Vaishnavi, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.